Honorable Chairperson and friends, a paper, Units of Space and Time, was jointly written by Dr. Rajmal Jain of ISRO Ahmedabad and myself. In fact, I have provided the canonical literature and the relevant material which is related with the mathematics. And Professor Rajmal Ji, who is a man of the astrophysics as well as the astronomy, he is a space scientist. He has compiled and analyzed the entire things related with the space and time. But due to sickness, he is not present here. So I'm trying to give the brief account of his paper, because a lot of analysis has been done. And the paper is of 42 pages. So it is not possible to read the entire paper, as well as I do not have the PowerPoint presentation of Dr. Rajmal Jain here. So I think that all of you bear with us, and we complete the formality of presenting the paper. The entire paper will be published either in the Journal of SOAS or in the separate, in the form of the booklet, which will be provided to all of you. As I have told you, the length of the paper is 42 pages. So I'm reading here the certain passages as well as the conclusion of the paper. Philosophy of space and time is concerned with the issues surrounding the ontology, epistemology, and character of space and time. While such ideas have been central to philosophy from its inception, the philosophy of space and time was both an inspiration for and a central aspect of early analytic philosophy. The earliest recorded Western philosophy of time was expounded by the ancient Egyptian thinker, and he said that, "Do not listen. The time of following desire for wasting of time is an abomination of the spirit." The Vedas, the earliest text on Indian philosophy and Hindu philosophy, dating back to the late 2nd millennium BC, describes ancient Hindu cosmology in which the universe goes through repeated cycles of the creation, destruction, and rebirth, with each cycle lasting 43,20,000 years. And ancient Greek philosopher, including Parmenides and Heraclitus, wrote essays on the nature of the time. On the contrary, Incas regarded space and time as a single concept named Pach. Paul and Catherine, on the other hand, Plato in the time Themis, identified time with the period of the motion of the heavenly bodies and space as that in which things come to Aristotle. In book 4th of his Physics, defined time as a number of changes with respect to before and after, and the place of the object as the innermost motionless boundary of that which surrounds it. But Augustine presented the first philosophical argument for the reality of the creation against Aristotle in the context of his discussion of time, saying that knowledge of time depends upon the knowledge of the movement of the things, and therefore time cannot exist as begin without creatures or motions. In contrast to the ancient Greek philosophers who believed that the universe had an infinite past with no beginning, medieval philosophers and theologists developed the concept of the universe having a finite past with the beginning. This view was inspired by the creation belief shared by the three non-Vedic religions, also called as Abrahamic religions, Judaism, Christianity, and Islam. The Christian philosopher John Philoponos presented another early arguments against the ancient Greek notion of infinite past. His views were adopted by many, including most notably early Muslim philosophers Al-Kindi, Jewish philosopher Sadia Gaon, and Muslim theologian Al-Ghazali. They used his two logical arguments against an infinite past. The first, before the argument from the impossibility of the existence of an actual infinite, which states that an actual infinite cannot exist. An infinite temporal regress of events in an actual infinite, however, an infinite temporal regress of events cannot exist. The second argument, the argument from the impossibility of compiling an actual infinite by successive additions, states that the temporal series of the past events has been completed by successive addition. But the temporal series of the past event cannot be an actual infinite. Both arguments were adopted by later Christian philosophers and theologians. And the second argument in particular became more famous after it was adopted by the Immanuel Kant in his thesis of the first anatomy concerning time. In 1788, Immanuel Kant published the Critics of the Pure Reasoning, one of the most influential works in the history of philosophy of the space and time. He describes time as an a priori notions that the, together with other a priori notions, such as a space, allows us a comprehensive sense experience. Kant denies that either space or time or substance entities in them are learned by experience. He holds rather than both are elements of a systematic framework we use to structure our experience. Spatial measurements are used to qualify how far apart objects are, and temporal measurements are used to quantitatively compare the interval between events. Although space and time are held to be transcendently ideal in the space, they are empirically real. The great debate between defining notions of the space and time as real objects themselves are more ordering upon actual objects. Objects begin between physicist Isaac Newton and Gottfried in the papers of the Leibniz-Clark comprehensive argument. Arguing against the absolutist positions, Leibniz offered a number of thought experiments with the purpose of showing that there is a contradiction in assuming the existence of the fact, such as absolute location and velocity. These arguments stayed heavily on two principles central to his philosophy: the principle of the sufficient reason and identity of the indiscriminable. The principle of the sufficient reasons holds that that for every fact, there is a reason that is sufficient to explain what and why it is the way it is, not otherwise. The principle of identity of indiscriminable states that if there is no way of telling two entities separate them, then they are one and the same thing, which, however, is not valid due to restriction in observing limits. Now, we, in contrast to the religious and particularly Jainism, the science is more recent but well developed and quantifies units more precisely. Currently, we read, talk, and write each quantity in units of science, which is rather better understandable. In this context, we compare units of space and time described in Jainism and other religions' domains with currently known units in science, units of time. Conversion of the units of time in Vedang Jyotish. We have taken the units of time in different cultures, and in Vedang Jyotish, 10.05 kals is equal to 1 nadika, and 2 nadika is equal to 1 muhurt, and 30 muhurts is 1 ahoratra, and ahoratra means day and night. On the other hand, Athar Jyotish defined time with better resolution as presented here. 12 nimish is 1 love, 30 lover is 1 kal, and 30 kals in 1 truti, and 30 trutis is 1 muhurt, and 30 muhurt is 1 ahoratra. According to L. Sibaya, 1 nimish is equal to 27 divided by 125 second of the modern science. On the other hand, a new table enables us to estimate different values of nimish to second. 1 muhurt is equal to 3,24,000 nimishes, and another 1 muhurt is equal to 2,880 seconds. So this is the difference between the Vedang Jyotish and the Athar Jyotish, and due to this, so many difference in the calculation takes place. However, we find that there was a lot of discrepancy and diversity in subunits of time in general, and in nimish, trutis, love, etc., in particular during Vedic era, though we do not consider detailed discussion on other forms of the units of time, but briefly, we would like to present Vedic sub-multiple units of the time, particularly sub-unit of nimish. 2 parmanu, 1 anu, and 3 anu barabar, 1 trashenu, 3 trashenu in 1 truti, and 100 trutis is equal to 1 vide, and 3 vide, vedha barabar equal to 1 love, and 3 love is equal to 1 nimish. It may not be noted that 1 nimish is equal to 16,200 parmanu. So in this way, we find 1 parmanu kal, atomic time, is equal to 543 nanosecond. But in Jaina system, there are two types of time. One is the Vyavaharkal and another is the Nishchaykal. And after a long discussion and mathematical formulation, author established that a relation between the Vyavaharkal and Nishchaykal, he said that the Vyavaharkal is the function of Nishchaykal as well as the energy. ETR is equal to function of EXYZT0, where EXYZ stand for the energies and the T0 is for the Nishchaykal. The Jayana units of time, the smallest part of time is equal to one samay, and one jaghanya yukta asankhyas samay is equal to one avalika, and 4,456 and 2,458/3,773 avalikas is equal to one pran, seven pran is one stok, seven stok is one lav, and 38.5 lav is one ghati, two ghatis is one muhurt, 30 muhurt is equal to one ahoratra, and 30 ahoratra is equal to one mass, and 12 mass is equal to one varsh. And this gives us the one muhurt is equal to 16,77,72,16 avalikas, means 1 second is equal to 5,825.42 avalikas. In order to estimate the muhurt in terms of samay, Jain canons classify counting system as I have given in my talk yesterday, that there are classification of number in countable, uncountable, and infinite. There are three type of countable, nine type of uncountable, and nine type of anant. So this classification, out of this, the asankhya time period is used in refining the samaya. So that is related with this very thing also. And he said the first order number is sankhyat, asankhyat, and anant, and second order is parit, yukt, and asankhyat. So nine type of asankhyat are connected with the parit, jaghanya madhyam, and asankhyat, and yukta jaghanya madhyam and asankhyat, and asankhyat is again jaghanya madhyam and asankhyat. The second order category has been further split into three more subcategories as follows. Jaghanya means minimum, and madhyam, middle, and utkrist is the maximum and highest. It may be noted that the above subcategories by large and quantitatively based and are not defined precisely. This is the opinion of the Rajmalji that this type of division as well as the interrelationship is not clearly defined, but as I differ from the first author in this respect, because the classification is very clear, and as in the first lecture of Munishi Mahendra Kumarji, the book which is presented here, Enigma of Universe, in the Enigma of Universe, an interrelationship is given clearly, and the same thing was stated by Dr. Arasha in his several papers. So finally, he jaghanya yukta asankhyat derived 7.58 × 10⁻⁓ raised to the power 7.58 × 10⁻³, and in this way, one samay is equal to 1.764 × 10⁻⁴ − 1469 × 10⁻⁡ This type of classification was approximated by Rajmalji. However, we are not convinced on the calculation of J from quantitative statement, and hence the final estimated value of the samay may not be correct. Authors do not recommend considering samay's value for any further estimation calculation. Nevertheless, above relation shows that samay is extremely smaller than Parmanukal. So finally, we can say that the definition of the samay is still a point of the research, and a lot of work should be done in this very field. And units. This subject matter was discussed by a well-known Indian mathematician, Aryabhatta, in his Aryabhatti. I think that all of you, those who are related with the Indian mathematics, will be acquainted with the Aryabhatti of the Aryabhatta. That is a work which is composed in 476 AD and very popular in Indian mathematics. In Aryabhatti, we find that 60 gurus, aksharas, that the time taken in pronouncing the 60 guru aksharas is one vandadika, and 60 vandadika is equal to one nadika, and 60 nadika is equal to one ahoratra, that is one day and night. The Aryabhattiyam Siddhantic system of the 60-fold universe division of each unit was well established and employed more frequently. Further, it is not close to current modern time units, which also has the 60-fold dimensions 60-fold division system and thus better comparable with modern units. However, the least unit is anibhati, is time taken to pronounce one guru akshar, i 24/60 means 0.4 second, and you can say that 400 milliseconds. After that, a table is created for Sushma Sushma, Sushma Sushma Dukma, Dukma Sushma Dukma, and Dukma Dukma time period, which is consecutively is 1,68,000, 1,26,000 years, 84,000 year, 42,000 year, 21,000 year, and 20,000 year. So the Shatkal Parivartan are the six periods has been defined and estimated in terms of the years. Now, there is a lot of deviation. Yesterday, one scholar asked me why 84 lakhs is given so much importance. Whenever Parva, Parvang, Tuttuttang, Maha, Lalat, Lalitang, etc., this type of the table which is available in so many cosmological texts, like Aniyogdwar Sutra, like in Jyotish Karandak, like in Jambudhi Parnati Sangho, in Tiloy Parnati, in Tatwarth Rajvartik, or Shlokvartik, which is a paper presented here in the morning on Akalankas, Antlanga Tatwarth Rajvartik. So this table is also available in the Tatwarth Rajvartik. And you will find that the division is so important, or we can say exists in so many prominency, that the highest unit, highest countable number, that is Utkrishta Sankhyat. So a number, Shirsh Prahelika, is in Shatama tradition we find, according to Aniyogdwar Sutra, one Shirsh Prahelika is 84 raised to the power 31 into 10 raised to the power 140. And in Jyotish Karandak, it is 84 raised to the power 36 into 10 raised to the power 180. While in the Digamba tradition, we will find that in Tiloy Parnati, the value is 84 raised to the power 31 into 10 raised to the power 90, and this is called as one Achalatma. And one Achalatma is equal to 84 raised to the power 31 into 10 raised to the power 155 in the Tatwarth Rajvartik. So deviation exists in two traditions as well as in the text of the both the traditions. In Shlokvartik, in Rajvartik, and Jambudvip Parnati Sangho, we find the 80 raised to power 31 into 10 raised to power 155. While in the Tiloy Parnati, Traloksar, we find the value of Achalam 84 raised to power 31 into 10 raised to power 90. But the important thing is 84 exists in everywhere. In all the texts, whenever this type of table is developed, first one is 84 lakhs times. Next one is the 84 lakhs time of the previous one. And this table, in one we find every term is 84 lakhs time. And in another book we find one is 84 lakhs time and another is only 84 times. So this is the reason due to which this difference takes place. But the important thing, 84 exists everywhere, but I do not have an answer why they have taken. Why in the present system, 1, 10, 100, 1,000, 10,000, everyone is 10 times. So it is said the decimal place value system. And what is the reason for taking 84 times or 84 lakhs time? No one knows, but it exists. It is unanimously adopted in all the traditions. And not only this, but in the Vedic tradition also and the Buddhic tradition also. After that, some charts has been prepared by Professor Rajmalji, and then he estimated and presented a new view about Koda Kodi Koli. And we know that Koda Koli is 10 raised to power 7 into 10 raised to power 7 means 10 raised to power 14. 10 raised to power 1 and then 14 times 00. But he suggested that Koda means 1000 and Koda means 100 and Kodi means 10, and this will disturb the entire calculation which is given here. But anyhow, I respect him, and this is his suggestion which is submitted by him as a first author. Now, regarding a space unit also, there are big tables is available in all the texts related with the cosmology, Tiloy Parnati, Traloksar, Jambudvip Parnati Sangho, Aniyogdwar Sutra, Jambudvip Pragati, Surya Pragati, Chandra Pragati, etc. And according to that, the infinitely many Parmanu is equal to 1 of Sannasan Iskanda, 8 of Sannasan Iskanda is equal to 1 Sannasan Iskanda, etc. And after that, a very important thing which is quoted by him is 1 Atma Yojan is equal to 9 1 upon 11 means 44.55 kilometer, and one Utsed Yojan is about 5 miles, and one Pramana Yojan is equal to 4,545.45 miles, that is equal to 7,315.19 kilometer. So this is the, because Yojan is a very prominent unit which is discussed, and all the measurement is based on the yojan. And there are two types of yojan. One is the simple yojan, another is the mahayojan. And after that, a relation between the space unit and time unit was also established. And this is x is equal to, yani suchangul, x is equal to p raised to the power logarithmic base 2 p. And another relation is j x cube log p upon a with base 2. And this will interrelate the time unit with the space unit. And this unique relation is available in the Tillopanati of Acharya Yati Vrishab, which is composed in the 2nd century AD. And certainly, the present version will have so many changes. So people assign him between 473 to 609. But initially, it is composed in the 2nd century. And after that, he has derived, given certain questions, and finally, this article was a great opportunity. In context of the macro units, we also consider description and derivation of units of the celestial objects for better understanding of the cosmological distances in the universe. We first describe in great detail the concept of the diurnal and declination circles in Jainism. We give examples of the distance estimated for the Earth from the Sun and Moon. Estimation of the zodiacal existence of the planet and nakshatras has been presented. There is a complete list of the 27 type of nakshatras as well as their inclinations are given in this very paper. Estimation of the zodiacal extension of the planets and nakshatras has been presented. It has been noted that the Jain astronomy could not correctly arrive on real distance of the planet, Sun and Moon from the Earth, because he is an astrophysicist and he is related with the ISRO. So he said that the details and the distances which is given in our text was not accurate. But I can assume that there are limitations. And it is my of the opinion that the distances which is given in the Jain text are very good. And he estimated. We also consider the estimation of the extension of the Jain universe, 14 Raju in modern units, and found that one Raju is equal to 1 into 10 raised to power 23 kilometers, or we can say 1.5 giga light years. This exercise enabled us to compare the units of space and time from microscopic to macroscopic scales in Jainism with that described in the modern science. So it is a very thought-provoking paper. So many details are given. I have provided him the data related with the canonical literature. He analyzed with the point of view of the modern science. So if there is a controversy or if there is any question, I'm ready to forward to Professor Rajmalji, and because he is an authority, and he will give the answer of the question, which is points which is raised by him.
Thank you very much.